the fallow deer. I'm just starting to get back on some of the estates that I've not been on for the summer because I've only really got fallow and muntjac on them. And so now all the crops are off, a lot of the beans have been cut, and we're seeing a lot on the stubble fields and that. So tonight I'm out with my son Dan, or one of my sons Dan, my middle son Dan, hopefully trying to get a fallow buck. So we'll go and have a look. It's about 6 o'clock. We've got about two and a half hours of light left. We're going to stalk along this field and woodland edge and then get up a seat and then get back out on the fields for the last light. So let's go and see what we can do, mate.
Let's do it. Thank you.
just in the middle of something. Starting to mark. This is a footing stamp I'm walking upon. In a month's time. There down the road, we're just going to stand and wait. It's a great potatoes. Stumped down this ride because we saw one youngster, and it was actually a group of dogs that have clocked us. They're sneaking off. I was hoping there'd be a boyfriend hanging around, but anyway, that's stalking for you. We've just had a great half an hour trying to get into them. It's not always about the kill. It's the experience of being so close to nature. But on this occasion, fallow deer and one Cervus-UK now. Sells out on a nice little ride. You can probably hear in the background a muntjac barking. So we're going to give it 20 minutes up here and see what we see. Hopefully there's going to be a muntjac or some fallow move out onto the edge of the field. And we can get something in the bag.
Might be
on. Well, mate, that's that patience has paid off.
Does it again?
Well done, son.
Thank you.
Same seat as your younger brother.
Finally.
We spent a couple of days down in the Chilterns and got a fallow at first light that couldn't get on film, and we've been chasing around everywhere, but finally got Danny's first muntjac buck. We've been sat here for about half an hour. There's been a doe barking behind us, and it's a really thick little bit in the winter. It's one of my favourite places. You'll have seen on film that we've shot quite a few from here. Nice lush field on the side, very thick brambles and some nice open areas here, and that's where we've just took this buck down here. I can just show you, he came out on his ride, and then I saw I got the camera out, and then he walked down through here, and then he was milling around under these trees just doing his territory. And and spotted him. I thought he was going to come to our left and we wouldn't get him, but he turned around and come back, so I didn't even get a chance to give him a little call or anything. So anyway, we'll go and see what we've got. So well done, Dan, let's get down.
That's a cracker, mate. Lovely book.
Oh, lovely trophy for you. Look at that, absolute belter. Great shot on the shoulder. And well,
what a beautiful trophy. It's a pleasure to be out. Like this. I mean, we didn't have any luck, did we?
No, we've had a tough couple of days, haven't we, to be fair. And last morning, what we found. Nice old buck. Lovely and equal by the look of it.
Yeah.
Nice brow tines. That's great, mate.
Can I hang a ring on each side?
Just take it out into the light a little bit and we'll get some nice photographs. Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Happy with that?
Yeah, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Over the moon. Completely.
Well done.
First Muntjac book.
All the films you make for me, you're actually on a film now, so well done, yeah.